we will see how to develop a project in automation in the energy and utility market. If you have any questions or comments, you can use the chat zone. We will answer your questions at the end of the webinar. I am Pascal Girard at Stratum Automation Worldwide Sales. After 25 years of development for industrial software, followed by 10 years in sales, I'm here at Stratum Automation since nearly 3 years, enjoying to find with our customers worldwide the best solution in the industries of automation, embedded, energy and utilities. And now, Anthony.
Hello everyone, my name is Anthony Muril. I work at Stratum Automation since more than 7 years now. I started as a tester, then I did some support, trainings and pre-sales, and now I lead the customer services team for Stratum, meaning tests on new things implemented in Stratum, pre-sales, support and trainings once Stratum is in use. And just one more thing, some of our customers already finished or at least started certifications for their products implementing our IEC 61850 and IEC 6870 stacks. So I also participated to help them in this process.
Thank you, Anthony. At first, let us have a look on the agenda of this webinar. I will be with you during the first 20 minutes. We'll start by a brief presentation of our company and what we do. Then we'll see the constraints of a project in energy, and after, the essential tools we need for the best efficiency. This will be followed by an exclusive demo from Anthony, how to quickly implement an IEC 850 architecture. We'll finish the demo by showing how to complete this architecture transmitting data to SCADA. And at the end, questions and answer. Please use the chat place to send your question whenever you want. We are Stratum Automation in the COPPA Data Group. We have the same goal since more than 20 years, developing automation software, soft PLC Stratum and Xenon SCADA. What do these two software have in common apart from the fact that we are part of the same group using the same tools and rules? It's a win-win, I should say. Our famous energy stacks are coming from COPPA Data, and COPPA Data is using our logic, Xenon logic. The combination of the two softwares in an application is very efficient. And here, in French Alps, we develop software for industrial automation, which includes an editor, a soft PLC, the runtime, and other tools and stacks. Our goal is to develop the best software, always including new features to bring sustainable competitive advantages to our customers. Some figures? This year, we have reached over 350,000 runtimes installed worldwide. And we are working with many partners since more than 15 years. We are active all over the world thanks to our extensive network made from COPPA Data local subsidiaries and distributors, represented by the blue points. We are very strong in energy and utilities. That means electricity, water, gas management. We address manufacturers of remote terminal units or equipments like a disconnecting device, a protection relay. Our customers name also it modular programmable controller or telecontrol or telemetry. In electricity for its production, and not only for renewable energy, solar farms or windmills, but also for its transport, for the substation automation and smart grids, and its distribution. We are in water distribution for clean or wastewater and for irrigation with DNP3. We are in rail at substations and TCMS. TCMS is train, control and management system. And also for telecommunication for managing energy. We are also in cruising line ships because they have to manage energy produced on board. If you recognize your application here, feel free to participate and let me know in the chat your questions and comments. Thanks. Now we will see what are the constraints of a project in energy and or utilities and how to manage this. It's the landscape today. We will start by the challenges we have to face currently. First challenge is aging transport and distribution infrastructure. We have to replace old equipment, sometimes mechanics, sometimes analogic, with new technologies. Standards are always evolving, even more in the energy market. We have always new energy sources to connect, renewables, energy storage systems, many things to connect. Digitalization is another challenge for facilitating control, maintenance, and debug. We virtualize the management of networks. And today, security is an issue that companies cannot ignore. Every day, new organizations are victims of hacking. And in the energy sector, these risks are even more important to take into account. We must have reliability and resiliency. Demand is increasing. And today, as a manufacturer of utility equipment, you have to face all these challenges. In fact, these are creating opportunities for increased industrial efficiency and productivity. And to take advantage of these opportunities and stay ahead of the competition, you need the right software system that can scale and grow with your business. Let's see now a kind of topology of the equipment into an electrical substation. You have controllers and stations. There are different kinds of systems, BMU, BCU, and protection, bay controlling unit or bay monitoring unit. These are connected through Ethernet network. Controllers are communicating each other with Goose protocol. Communication on IC850 client server through MMS, and the client computer exchanges with SCADA on IEC 870. We name also it IEC 101 or IEC 104. You see, IEC 850 is a standard for electricity known worldwide, and you are a company making BCU for energy, for instance. They are controlling safety circuit breakers in a substation. Market is changing with digitalization and cybersecurity. You must have your equipment talking the same language, IEC 850. Now let's see your constraints. First, as you need to add logic and computation to your equipment, it's just one brick to add, I should say. You want to standardize at maximum your future developments. That means if you have more than one device in the catalog, you'll have the same tool to program, configure, and maintain diagnostics. Whatever the hardware, a unique tool for all developers. You can organize the code of your applications in order to use at maximum common parts of software with common stacks or libraries, for instance. Also, using the standard of PLC Open gives you the maximum benefit because resources are easy to find. And you get standardization of the protocols with the IEC 850. You know, in order to exchange the device descriptions and system parameters between tools of different manufacturers in a compatible way. The IEC 815-6 defines the substation configuration language, the SCL. This is standardization. We also need efficiency for best time to market. You need to develop in a short time and a fast integration of a soft PLC, a fast configuration. By this way, you can create easily IEC 850 models, logical nodes, logical device, the famous interoperability. You need openness. IEC 850 is not the only protocol needed. There are other networks to connect. You may want to connect this world to any kind of equipment, having Modbus, CAN bus, Profinet, Ethernet IP, DNP3, IEC 870. You must connect also to this kind of networks. Openness. It's also agility. The evolution of standard in this industry is too speed and would take too much resources for you. And I don't mean developing your own stack. IEC 850 protocol is huge, complex, and is regularly evolving. So you want to rely on an expert for the knowledge, in particular when you will have to certify your products. It's an important step. And also to getting the latest evolutions of the standard and its maintenance. Then you can focus on your business. One constraint is also digitalization. For some of you, part of the logic is not local, but is done remotely on high-end industrial PCs. Your app has to handle it. We are exactly at the concept of soft PLC, virtualization of a logic. And cybersecurity, very important. You want your communication to be secured. That means at least authentication, encrypting. And last point, financials. You want to master your budget all along your product lifecycle. You've checked supplier for IEC 850. They are numerous, and you don't think your resources and budget can be enough for developing it by yourself. And you know you will have to make certification of your products. It's a big effort. Does this figure summarize your challenges? Please use the chat zone if you have questions or comments. Now, let us see what comes now with Straton proposal. First, Straton Automation is recognized in the energy market for its expertise and its stable and flexible stacks. For instance, let's remind the story of IEC 850. It has started to be developed in 2006. Using its latest standards brings interoperability with any other IEC 850 device. And we have been working with the energy industry for many years, and we focus on secured communication. All our energy protocols and even some others are included now with data crypting and authentication, TLS. And to be able to exchange the device descriptions and system parameters between tools of different manufacturers in a compatible way, IEC 856 defines the substation configuration language, this famous SCL. The complex topology is made simple by using our IEC configuration tool, IEC 850 configuration tool, which is in IDE. You will see with a demo from Anthony. We have a complete offer, all the tools to develop, configure, and maintain a project in energy and utilities industry. IEC 850, fully integrated into editor and runtime, SCL editor, configurators, and debugging tools. and we support closely our customer during the phase of certification of their RTUs. Some of our customers who integrate our IEC 850 client and server stacks in their device are certified IEC 850 Edition 2 by DNVGL. Second point is a reduced programming and configuration time. Straton gives the most reduced programming and configuration. Why? A standard for programming that any people in automation knows. Easy to go. An integration of a runtime in any kind of hardware that can be done in 2 days. It's also a big library and many function blocks, which makes easy and reduces programming time. And all the tools to manage automation and electrical networks aspects of the project are given with efficiency, development, configuration, and maintenance. I will get the communication stacks plug and play by this way, and the library given with the editor and the SLA editor. Don't worry, you will have a nice demo for that soon from Anthony. And now let's see some references of our product with devices made by our partners. We can see modular programmable controllers. We can see substation automation system managing IEC 850 and IEC 101-104, the other word for IEC 61870. Protection and control relays for railways substation, telecommunications and electricity distribution, smart telecontrol units, water distribution through DNP3, master and slave, or telemetry RTU. You see, I expect you got this nice top level presentation and you have enjoyed it. And now if you have any question, please use the chat box. Let us now see how it is easily done through a demo of an implementation with Anthony. Thank you all and let's go, Anthony.
Right. Thank you, Pascal, for this very interesting presentation. So let me just share my screen. Okay. This one. Okay. So for the ones who were already present at our first webinar, the title of the demonstration was quite enigmatic. But for this one, I guess you can already imagine what will be presented. The solution to create a complete but simple IEC 61850 architecture. To make it short, we will simulate a circuit breaker and connect an IEC 61850 client to it. And if we push the concept a little bit further, we can even make our 850 client acting as a gateway to exchange data points or commands with an IEC 6870 master or SCADA. Let's imagine. You have one or several substations. Substations are communicating between each other using the Goose protocol. We have an IEC 61850 client connected to it, and it communicates with the substations over MMS. And above that, an IEC 104 SCADA able to recover data and or send commands via the 870-5-104 protocol. And then let's assume everything comes from an independent manufacturer, which is completely okay, by the way, because as Pascal said, if everything is compliant with the standard, everything can communicate easily. So then you keep the interoperability between every element. Okay, then the first point is the creation of the SCL file, our 850 server configuration file. We will configure it to simulate a circuit breaker, send its values to a client through MMS, and communicate through internal information, like its internal status, to other servers with the Goose protocol. So in the worst case, we will need an SCL editor, then the editor to take it in account and create plus configure our HTTP server, then ideally an easy to use test tool to check that it runs well. Then we must configure our 850 client, and finally, the SCADA is configured with its own tool. But just forget it. For this demonstration, we will only use one editor with everything included. So you may think that for this, a quarter of an hour will be really short, which is not entirely wrong if you never heard about 850 and Straton. But I will try to explain everything in a simple way, and you will see that the basic configuration can be really fast. So I hope everyone is ready. We will focus on this part, creating and configuring an 850 server. Then do the same thing with the 850 client. So let's switch to Straton. So this is the editor. First of all, we will make a short overview about the editor. You see first in help languages that it's available in several languages. And if you check in help tutorials, you will see that in protocols, you have a lot of tutorials. And here, especially tutorials for 850, 870, tutorials for DNP3, and most of the protocols we support in Straton. On the start page, you can see at the bottom here that we have a link to our website. So it's really, really interesting. And the overlinks are mainly leading to our website also, especially in the download section, you will be able to see every tutorials and products we can propose. So it's really useful because here you will have the very latest up-to-date tutorials and products. And another important link also is the link to our YouTube channel here, because on our YouTube challenge, we will have demo of configurations. For example, there are demo of what we will see today, creating an SCL file, an 850 server, an 850 client. So it's really interesting also to go on this YouTube channel. So let's first try to open the demo project list. Maybe I will zoom in on a few elements. So the editor looks like that. On the top left, you have your project list with the list of projects you have. So you can see that in the demo project list, you already have an Energy 681850 server application. Here at the middle, you have the workspace, sorry, the main window. So in the main window, you have every programs and things you are opening in the editor. Here it's in FBD. On the top right, the list of variables, and here the list of blocks available to program your application. So it's sorted by groups. So you can see here the NP3, the blocks linked to the NP3, and the blocks linked to 850, for example, linked to 850. And at the bottom, you have the output window. The output window, when you will compile your application, so every warnings and messages about the application. And here, in the runtime output, you will have every output when you will be online and in debug mode. So let's go. We will start from a project skeleton. We will create our 850 server. So at first, we need the SCL file to configure our substation. So I right click in the project list here. I click on insert new item. And here I can see IEC 61850 SCL editor. So this is the integrated editor directly to Straton. So I choose a name. Okay. I just open it and I can see that now I have a simple editor, a graphical editor. So at first we will insert a new logical device describing our substation capabilities here. So we can choose between edition 1 or edition 2. So depending on what you choose, you will have more or less logical nodes, logical devices, logical data objects, things like that. So it's really, really strongly linked to the standard. So if I click on OK, for example, you can see that by default, it proposes to declare the logical node 0. Here also, extracted from the standard, you have a description for logical node 0. You have every details. You can see the mandatory data objects here in gray. You can see the optional ones. And if you want to edit it, you can edit the command data class. And you can see again that you can see mandatory data attributes this time. And if you edit it, you can add the optional data attributes. So it's really fully standardized. So it's really easy to use. And you will see that it will be easy to create our 850 server. So we had the logical node zero, okay. The LPHD, so the general device information, okay. And now we said we will need a circuit breaker. So I click here, create a new logical node. And if you are familiar with the standard, you know that circuit breaking logical nodes starts with an X. So if we go here in the X, we type X on our keyboard and we see circuit breaker, XCBR. So circuit breaker, and here few of the data objects already checked, the mandatory ones, and we have optional ones also. So we will take the position, it's already checked, and we will make it blink. So we click on OK, and we said we want to communicate, for example, the logical device health to other substations. So we'll use the goose for that. So at first, I create a new data set. I will call it DSGO. So I know it's the data set for the goose. I just double click on it. I choose to communicate logical node zero health. So the data object health over the goose. OK. And we want to communicate also the position of the circuit breaker to an 850 client, for example. So I create a new dataset position. I double click on it. I go to the circuit breaker position. I check it. And this is OK. Now I have to configure my report control blocks. So the reports using this dataset. So I just create for the goose, add a goose report control block. Okay. I choose a name, my gRCB, for example, a description, a dataset. So here I take the dataset for the goose, an app ID. Okay. And here I have parameters also from the standard, of course. I add a new report control block to communicate the circuit breaker position. Either a buffered one or an unbuffered one, it doesn't matter for this demonstration. I choose that this linked to the dataset position. And here again, every options from the standard, like the optional fields, the trigger options to send the report and things like that. If I have some doubts on what I configured, here I have a button, check syntax. So if I click on the button, it will check the syntax of the whole SCL file. And if it will check if it corresponds to the standard, what is mandatory or not in the standard. So I think to click on save, to save the SCL file. And now I go in the Filebus configuration. And I will use this SCL file to communicate to other servers or to other 850 clients. So I simply right-click on the configuration. Read variables from SCL file. I click on insert. I go where the project is. Sorry, I don't remember exactly. So I press Ctrl+E. I will copy the path here. Okay, again, read variable from SCL file. Insert, it should be here. I can see that this is the file I just saved. Okay. And now I can see every data attributes listed here. So under my logical device, my logical nodes, my data objects, I have the data attributes to which I have access. So for example, if we want to modify the circuit breaker position, I go on XCBR1, position, estival, the status of the position, and LLN0BH health estival, if I want to communicate also the health of the logical device. So I click on OK. And now my variables are accessible directly in the dictionary. These have been created automatically by the editor. Just to be sure I'm checking right things on the client, I will make the position of the circuit breaker blinking just to have something more interactive. So I will create a new program. I right-click on the programs, insert new program. Here I see that I have different kind of programs. Available are the five languages of the 611.31-3. So function block diagram, sequential function chart, structured text, ladder diagram, and instruction list also, which has been kept for compatibility reasons. So for us, we will take an FBD program, and we'll call it the main program. I click on OK. I open the program, and if I want to make the position blinking, I will use a blink block. I simply drag and drop the block from the dictionary, from the list of the blocks here at the center of the window, in my editing window. I will create the variables, we run, okay. As it's in FBD, the editor knows automatically if the variable is created or not, and it proposes automatically the right type. So here a Boolean, and here be cycle blink, for example. Okay, it says it's a time. Okay, I will put an initial value to be sure. I will make the blink lasting 2 seconds off, 2 seconds on. I click on OK. And here, I will simply link my variable, my circuit breaker position from my dictionary. So the circuit breaker position, we can see that it's an unseen double integer. So I drag and drop it here. Okay. And as the blink block is outputting a Boolean, I will simply take a block, any two unsealed UDINT. Okay, I drag and drop it here. I create the links. I click on compile. Apparently, everything is fine. So for the moment, it's okay. I go online. It asks me, do you want to download this application now? I say yes. We can see very quickly that it downloads the STL files to the target. And now, if I click on B-Run, we will see that the circuit breaker position will blink from off to on, so from 0 to 1. So now my 850 server is running. So in this case, I transformed a Raspberry in a substation with a circuit breaker having the position blinking from 0 to 1. So if I go back again in the presentation, I told you that if you want to test it easily, you will need an easy test tool. So we have this in Straton. I will open another instance of the editor. It will be easier. Okay. Here I can go in Tools, Clients, IEC 61850 Client. And here I can see that I have a nice tool in which I can configure several connections. So here it's already created. You can choose the name of the connection, the address of the server, of course, and a lot of parameters. For example, here you can choose if you subscribe to report control blocks from the server. So from the ones who know it, it will remind you things. I click on import and you will see that I have access to the report from the server. So this is already a sign that it's working well. I click on OK. I connect to the server. And here, I can see everything available on the server. So even if earlier I mapped to my application only few variables, it doesn't mean that here on the client side, I have only these two variables, of course. So I can see everything. So if I go on the circuit breaker position, I can see that it's blinking. The timestamp is updated with the right date. So here it's 1 hour shifted, but it's okay. And STVAL is blinking from 0 to 1, like it's blinking in my 850 server application here. So the 850 server application is running well. My Raspberry is running well, but now I cannot make any logic. Of course, I can send commands from this test tool. So for example, here, if I want to set the control model to another value, I can double click on it and it sends it to the 850 server, but I cannot make any logic. I cannot make operations like if this is in this status, then I make an operation. So for this, making a logic, we will create an 850 client application like we created the 850 server. So this is it for the test tool. We will disconnect, and for the client, we will open a new project skeleton, and you will see that it's as simple as creating the server, even more. You have an 850 client configuration here. You insert a new server, We call it, for example, my server. You put the IP address of the server. Okay. The port number by default is 102, it's okay. Here you can configure things, of course. You click on OK, right click on configuration, read variables from the server, and automatically the client, so the editor here, will go to search every information we have on the server. So we can see everything and even more, because here we have access to things we don't have access on the server. So for example, information about the goose report control blocks, information about the unbuffered report control block. So here I can also check values and access to the health of the logical device, for example. I can access to the circuit breaker position. I can access the circuit breaker control model, for example. We will see that if what I write it just before it has been written correctly to the server. So I click on OK. It creates the architecture here. It creates the tree automatically. I can even insert a status variable to be sure I'm connected to the server. I build the application. I go online. I download the application on another runtime. So here the runtime is on my PC. And I can see that it's connected correctly. If I make a zoom here in the window, I can see that the control model position I write it from the tool before to four has been written correctly. And I can see that the circuit breaker position is blinking. So everything is fine. And connection status is fine also. So then I can create my programs, insert a new program. I click on OK. And then I have the list of blocks available here in the tree to use everything linked to the 850. So for example, to write a value, to make an operate on the circuit breaker position, a select before operate, cancel the operation, everything is available on the client. So you will see on YouTube, we have videos showing this. It's far more advanced than the demo today, but of course we don't have the time to do a full project here, but we see that already it works. So it's as simple as this. I will not go further. You can imagine that it's already used all around the world by our customers, so and already certified by two of them. So you can imagine it works well. So if I quickly switch back to the presentation, we created a basic SCL file. Maybe I will use this pointer. We created a basic SCL file for our substation. We created our substation configuration. We downloaded it to a Raspberry runtime here. So we transformed our Raspberry in an IEC850 substation with a circuit breaker blinking on it. We created the 850 client. In between, we checked that everything ran well with the 850 client. And this is already quite good. I told you that if we want to go further, we can make a gateway to push this 850 client data to a 104 SCADA. So this needs quite a bit of engineering, of course. I confess this is not so simple, as commands must be managed using state machines, depending on the type of commands you want to use, simple command, double command, analog, I don't know, and the type of data you want to exchange. So we'll not make the overall demonstration, but just to show you quickly in the editor, if we take the 850 client application, I simply have to insert a new configuration. Here you can see every protocols we support in Straton. I have the 870 slave in this case, because we will act as an 870 slave to forward the data to a SCADA. Okay, I create the configuration. You can see that 101 is supported for serial communication, 104 is supported for Ethernet-based communication. I configure it, and then it's the same principle as the other configurations. You just assign profiles to these variables, and then it will be forwarded automatically to the SCADA. So as I said, This is not fully transparent. So if you are interested, feel free to contact us, and especially think to check the tutorials available on our website or in help tutorials in the editor. Think also to check our YouTube videos. And again, do not forget to ask us if you have any questions, because we have a lot of already made sample projects. So don't lose too much time. So that's it. I hope you enjoyed this demonstration. And remember that if you want to test it by yourself, a sample of 850 server application is already available in Straton, as we saw at the beginning in the sample projects. And every video is explaining how to create an 850 application is also are also available on our YouTube channel. So if you have any questions, feel free to ask it in the chat on the right. And again, think to chat to check our videos on YouTube. And thank you again. So we are here to answer to your questions now.
Thank you, Anthony. Thank you, Anthony.
So does the server, we have a question here. I can see, does the server support the sample values? So not yet, this is implemented. So this is in the current roadmap. We already made a proof of concept for it. And it shows that it runs well. So probably soon we will have the sample values in our 850 stacks.
Yes, thanks for this question.
Thank you, yes. So if you have any doubts about what we support in our implementation, you can go in the help topics. It will open the Straton online help. And if you are familiar with everything about certification, you can see that we have protocol implementation conformance statement, the famous PICS. So if you type PICS here, it will open this PICS either for the server or for the client. So you can here see more details about what is supported by Straton and what is supported by the stacks. So don't hesitate to check it, and again, to ask us if you have any question, because there are a lot of things here. So it's really, really important to not get lost and to contact the support or Pascal if you have any question about 850, 870, DNP3, and even about Modbus. I don't know if you are using other specific protocols in your application, Modbus, MQTT, can open everything supported by Straton.
Exactly. Thank you, Anthony. Do you have other questions? Okay. Thank you all. So we can close this webinar. Thank you for your participation. And anyway, you will be able to review the webinar in replay mode later on. And we will also publish this webinar on our YouTube channel. As today, you can see the webinar for Embedded also in the YouTube channel. You will be able also to see this one in the next days. We thank you very much for your attention. Participation, and wish you a nice evening or nice day for others. And we say thank you and goodbye.
Thank you all. See you soon.